Hello, today we are going to learn about etching. Once the substrate has been coated or deposited with the films, desired films, and the lithography process has been performed, the next step for the creation of the MEMS devices is etching. So, in this presentation, we will going to learn about, first of all, the introduction to etching, and then the types of etching, wet chemical etching, dry etching, plasma etchings, and in the last, the different types of the plasma etch systems. So first of all, what is etching? Etching is just a material removal. So it is done either in a dry or a wet method. Wet etching uses liquid etchants with wafers immersed in the etchant solution. The wet etching is generally cheap and simple but hard to control and not popular for the nanofabrication for pattern transfer purposes. Dry etch uses gas phase etchants in plasma, either in chemical or physical, generally the sputtering process. Dry plasma etch works for many dielectric materials and some metals also. For other kinds of metal, iron milling can be used but with etching selectivity. As a result, for a metals that cannot be dry etched, it is better to pattern them using a lift-off processes. Now basically in an etching, it consists of three processes. The first step is the mass transport of the reactants to the surface to be etched. The second one is the reaction happening between the reactants and the film that has to be etched. And the last one is the mass transport of the reaction products from the surface to the surface boundary layer. So as we can see in this figure, that this is the substrate, this is the film, and this is the film where we want to be etched. So whenever there is a reactant, for example, this is a wet etching, then the chemical agents we are using for the etching, these are the reactants. They will slowly diffuse to the film. The reaction will happen, and after the reaction, the whatever reactant products will be formed, that will be out from the surface. So what things we have to consider? So what are the figures of the merits while processing in an etching process? One is the etch rate. What is the rate of etching? Then etch rate uniformity. It is uniform throughout the film or the pattern we want to make, or it is not uniform, we have to consider it. Then is the selectivity. And last one is the anisotropy. And this x distance is Vm perpendicular. Now the etching rates will for the different materials will be given by the etching, like the etching rate R1 is equals to A1 e raised to r minus q1 upon kt. Now R1 is the etching rate, A1 is a proportionality constant, and this q1 is the activation energy. Similarly, R2 is equals to etching rate, A2 is the proportionality constant, and q2 is the activation energy for the masking material. So this S is given by R1 upon R2, or in short we can write A1 upon A2, that is the proportionality constant, e raised to power minus activation energies Q1 and Q2 upon KT. So temperature generally affects etching. What is the effect of the temperature? If Q1 is less than Q2, then there is a relation between the selectivity and the temperature, and both are inversely proportional to each other. That means as temperature increases, the selectivity goes decreasing. Okay, so this is a graph between selectivity and inverse of a temperature. Now in this figure, we want to show how etching responds with the mask erosion. Now this is the before etching. This is our film. This is the mask. Now once etching is performed, the film is etched. Along with this, the mask is also etched in a particular direction. That means etching affects both the mask as well as the film. Now this is the selective over each of different materials. If we want to make a particular kind of device with a particular dimensions, this is the example. The film is etched through to the bottom plus over each to etch laterally for undercut profile. Once these layers are deposited, like this is a collector layer of indium phosphide, then this is a base, indium gallium phosphide, then this is gallium. So these are the different layers are deposited and etched in such a way that underneath we are having an undercut, while upper there is an anisotropic cuts. So this kind of MEMS devices can be possible with the help of the etching having different selectivities and different etch rates. Now the next figure of merit in consideration is the anisotropy. First of all, what is isotropy? Isotropic means the etch rate is same along all the directions. So for an isotropic material, the reactivity R1 is equals to 1. This is the example. The etching rate is uniform in all the direction. Now what is anisotropic? Anisotropic means etch rate depends on the direction, usually vertical as well versus horizontal. So there is a horizontal etch rate upon vertical etch rate. Now this is where the RI, the reaction is 0.5. So vertical increases, horizontal decreases. This is the overreach. Overreach means horizontal is more etched compared to the vertical one. And this is poor critical dimensional control in thick film using the wattage. In this, worse in the thick films. As the film thickness goes increasing, the critical dimensions becomes worse as the etching is not uniform and desired in all the directions. So for a material to be perfectly isotropic, the R1 reactivity should be equals to 1, and for the complete anisotropic, the R1 should be equals to 0. In this case, only there is a etching in the vertical and not horizontal directions. So isotropic, same etching in all the directions. Anisotropic, vertical is more, horizontal is less. And completely anisotropic, the whole etching is in the vertical direction. There is no etching in the horizontal direction. So generally speaking, chemical processes like wet etch or the plasma etch leads to isotropic etching, whereas physical processes like directional electroenergetic bombardments leads to anisotropic etch. As far as isotropic is concerned, this is best to use with the large features when sidewall slope does not matter and to undercut the mask for easy lifts-offs. The large critical dimensions are lost, generally not for the nanofabrication purposes. The isotropic etching is quick, easy and cheap. Anisotropic etching is best for making small features with vertical sidewalls, preferred pattern transfer method for nanofabrications and the microfabrication devices. Typically, it is more costly. Now, we will see how wet chemical etching process occurs. Wet etching was used exclusively till 1970s when feature size has to be made greater than 3 micron. For small scale features, large etch bias leads to significant critical dimension losses. So for the today's IC industry, wet etching is used for non-critical feature sizes only. What are the advantages of the wet etching? First, it is highly selective, high selectivity. Second one, relatively inexpensive equipment. Batch system with high throughput, each rate can be very fast, like it can etch up to many micrometers per minute. What are the disadvantages? Generally, isotropic profile, high chemical uses and poor process control, which are not so reproducible. Also, excessive particulate contamination. Because we are using, in a wet etching, we are using the chemicals. So there is a problem of contamination also. So simply there is a substrate, this is a photoresist. Now this is under etching, so this is etching, isotropic etching in all the directions, and after the mask retrieval this is the pattern we will see. The etch rate can be controlled by any of the three serial processes: either reactants transport to the surface, reaction rate, or the reaction products transport from the surface. Now the preference is to have reaction rate controlled, because each rate can be increased by the temperature. As the temperature increases, the chemical reactivity increases, so would the etch rate would also enhance. Now good control over the reaction rate where temperature of a liquid is easy to control. So the temperature is maintained throughout the etch process for a good control over the reaction rate. The mass transport control will result in a non-uniform etch rate. The etch etches faster. The edges will be etched faster comparatively. Etchant is often stirred to minimize boundary layer and make etching more uniform. Same, H2SI, F6, HNO2 plus H2O plus H2. Excess nitric acid results in a lot of silicon oxide formation and etch rate becomes limited by the HF removal of the oxide. So acetic acid or H2O can be added as a diluent, but the etch will be differently. Acetic acid is preferred because it prevents HNO3 oxidation. This is another example of etching of the aluminium. If you want to etch the aluminium, then phosphoric acid 50 moles, water 20 moles, HNO3 1 mole, and acetic acid 1 moles. This is the wet chemical agent for etching. The overall reaction will be, there will be the 6 H plus ions after forming this, which will react with the 2 aluminium molecules to form 3 H2 plus 2 Al. 3 plus. This Al plus 3 is a water soluble and is removed out. So aluminium etches in water, phosphoric, nitric and acetic acid mixtures. It converts aluminium to aluminium oxide with nitric acid, which involves H2 in the last. Dissolve Al2O3 in a phosphoric acid, gas evolution leading to bubbles. Local etch rate goes down where bubble is formed, leading to non-uniformity. Aluminium can also be etched in a diluted acid or base such as HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, NaOH or KOH, but less controllable. Etch the native oxide slowly and uncontrollably, then once oxide all etched away, etch aluminium metal very fast. So the etch seems more repeatable in the diluted HF 1:100. If one doesn't bother to mix the above mixture, we can go through to 1:100 diluted HF solution. Now this is the summary slide showing what are the different types of etchants are, what they etches and what they doesn't etch. For example, I want to etch a particular polymer layer. So nowadays polymers are being mostly used in many of the applications. So if we want to etch a polymer, we have to use a combination of NH4OH and H2O2. This does not etch silicon, silicon oxide, silicon nitride. So in the IC fabrications, we can't go to this particular solution. These are the different solution combinations. These are the what the materials they are etching, and these are what materials they are don't etching. Okay, this is the summary. What is M stands for, what is PR, photoresist, all that, go through it. Okay, next we are studying anisotropic etching of the crystalline silicon in particular. Why we are concentrating more on silicon than silicon? Because in generally MEMS devices, we are talking about the micro electromechanical devices. The electro part comes in the semiconductors, and the most prominent semiconductor being used in the industry is the silicon. Similarly, if you watch to silicon oxide, KOH, the rate is this. For the EDP, the rate is. Effect of slow etching with KOH. Etching virtually stops at 111
planes. So this is 100 plane, etching is there, but when there comes a 111 plane, the etching will be much less and there is a stoppage. So this kind of structure is formed. This is a silicon wafer in a 100. This is a 111 orientation. So this is the particular angle. This is the etch mask. So KOH is not affecting SiO2 or nitrides or chromium or aluminium. So generally the mask of these materials can be used on the silicon. These are the examples how etching can lead to the formation of different kind of micro structure. This is the scale of 100 micron. So generally these are technique is used for making the bubble jet printer nozzles. The size, as you can see, it is a 40 micron size. This is 40 micron size we are using to make it. Other than this, we can also make AFM tips using the methods. And thus there is a wafer. Okay, this is the mask. Then this is the etching part we have done, and this particular structure can be used as a pressure sensor. These are the pit-like structures formed using the etching. This is the figure showing the etch stop by using increasing the boron concentration. So as the boron concentration increases, the etch rod suddenly, after a concentration of 10^19 to 20 molecule atoms, it suddenly decreases. So this is the etching direction, this is the mask we are having, this is the layer we are having. So heavily doped boron has to be implanted where the etch has to be stopped. For MEMS. Now plasma based etching. Directional etching due to presence of ionic species in plasma and self-biased electric field. The two components exist in the plasma: ionic species, which results in directional etching, and secondly is the chemical reactive species, which results in high etch selectivity. The control of the ratio of the ionic to the reactive components in plasma can modulate the dry etching rate and the etching profile. So this is the plasma, which is having the neutrals, ions, free radicals. These are absorbed on the surface. The reaction will happen and the gaseous products will be released out. Silicon plus fluorine, this is SiF4. RF plasma is the most popular one. RF plasma is more widely used for the dry etching than the DC plasma. Is there DC plasma dry etching? You have to look after. For a plasma with inlet flow of molecule AB, plasma processes are, first is the dissociation of the molecule. So this AB react with the ion and forms A plus B plus this ion. This will lose the energy. The star is the energy, activation energy. Then atomic ionization. Again, there will be striking of the ionic species with the molecule and this will be converted into an ion, A plus. Then molecular ionization, it can be converted into AB plus. Atomic excitation, simply A dot, it is converted into. At molecular excitation, AB dot. So in wholesome in the plasma, we are having A or B or A plus or AB plus or A ionic or AB ionic plus the energetic ions. In a plasma, unstable particles are continuously generated. The concentration of ions, radicals, active atoms, and electrons increase until their loss rate is equal to the generation rate, forming a steady state plasma. That is, till equilibrium is reached. Now, the recombination of ions and the electrons, they attract each other and are annihilated. Drift or diffusion to the walls. Electrons are lost at the conductive surface, chamber walls, or the electrode. So ions are lost by contact with the conductive surface, especially positive electrodes. Recombination can also happen of the ions, like 2O nascent can combine to form an oxygen molecule. Chemical reaction, like 4 F plus Si, SiF4. Fluorine radical combines with the silicon wafer to produce silicon tetrafluoride gas. This is a typically dry etch process. In equilibrium, degree of ionization is typically 10⁻³ to 10⁻⁶, very low, meaning majority gas is not ionized. The plasma density to reach ionoid should be typically of 10⁻⁹ to 10⁻³ per cubic centimeter. What is in plasma? We can better understand plasma TV. In a plasma TV, the recombination of ion electron or a radical or de-excitation of an atom or a molecule generates the colorful light. Now, what is the plasma etching? In a plasma, reactive neutral species like free radicals, like for example fluorine atoms or molecular species, are mainly responsible for the chemical reaction due to their much greater numbers compared to the ions. CF plus 3 is also reactive, but with low concentration in the plasma. But argon plus is not reactive and HS sputters much lower than the chemical etching. Even when ion energy is high, generally chemical etching is much faster than the physical. Those free radicals and molecules also serve as a primary deposition species in the plasma enhanced CVD. These free radicals are more abundant than ion because firstly they are generated at a lower threshold energy. Secondly, they have longer lifetime in the plasma. The neutral radicals arrive at the cathode surface by diffusion. The charged ions are accelerated to the cathode due to self-bias. Unless with high energy of greater than 100 electron volt, as in an ion beam or sputtering etch, ion itself doesn't contribute significantly to the chemical reaction, mostly due to its very low concentration. So even if it is having high energy, there is not a significant contribution. But ion bombardment can greatly enhance the chemical reaction in ion-enhanced etching. So concentration is less, but if these less concentrated are bombarded throughout, then the reaction rate increases. Due to their incomplete bonding, free radicals are highly reactive chemical species. So when an electron, loose electron, reacts with a CF4, CF3 plus fluorine plus an electron, a free radical is formed. So free radical reacts with film, this F, which reacts with the film to be etched and form volatile byproduct. So this free radical of fluorine reacts with silicon surface Si plus 4F to form SiF4. Pure chemical etch is isotropic or nearly isotropic, and the etching profile depends on arrival angle and the sticking coefficients of free radicals. Free radicals that are uncharged in the plasma systems have isotropic arrival angles. This is isotropic in all the directions, the arrival rate is the same. The sticking coefficient S is very low, typically only of the order of 0.01. That is, most of the free radical adsorb then just bounce back without reaction. This leads to isotropic character of the etching. That's why there is isotropic etch. As free radicals can etch area beneath the mask due to bouncing, as can be seen in the figure, the resulted fluorine has a large undercut. These free radicals can come with an equal probability in all the direction. They don't stick because the sticking coefficient is only 0.01%, and they are bounced back, and that's why there is a undercut profiles under the mask. Most adsorbed species just left the absorption site without doing anything when S is less than 0. So for isotropic etching, S should be less than 1. But in case of anisotropic etching, it should be 1, near to unity. That means the ions absorbed, ions are coming through this way. Okay, once the ions are coming, they are absorbed at the particular site 100%, the ideal condition, and they are etching in the same direction, in the vertical direction. This is the completely anisotropic reaction. The reaction here, momentum transfer by the physical bombardment takes place as very short particular, usually sputter of the atom, so the S is equals to 1. So this is the sticking coefficient graph. Now, the physical etch component in a plasma etch system. Ionic species are accelerated towards each electrode by built-in self-bias. The ionic species such as chlorine, carbon tetrafluoride, carbon trifluoride, strike water surface and remove the material to be etched. Strike the wafer surface and removes the material that has to be etched. Directional, of course, non-selective, chemical sputter yield for different kinds of the materials. It may result in a significant redeposition. Pure physical etch is a sputtering system, which is a self-bias system operating at above 100 volt, but low ion energy due to collision energy losses. Thus, very low milling rate in a sputter system, often for surface cleaning only. Here is the case for sputtering etching system with a gas pressure under 10 millitor. For a dedicated ion milling system, that is no plasma, the pressure is 10 raised to power minus 4 tor or even lower, leading to large mean free path, high ionic energy and higher milling rates. Now is ion enhanced etching. Chemical etch assisted by the physical bombardment. This is ion enhanced. It is anisotropic due to directional ion bombardment and highly selective due to chemical reaction etching process. So reactive ion etch is the most popular form of ion enhanced etching. Ion bombardment can enhance one of the following steps during chemical etch: surface adsorption or etching reaction by physically damaging or weakening the chemical bonds of the material to be etched, byproduct inhibitor layer removal and removal of the unreacted etchants. So these are the ionic species, chemical etch, enhancement by ion bombardment. This is the ionic species, bombardment, and these are the inhibitor removed by the ion bombardment. The inhibitor layer can be example of fluorocarbon polymer formed from CHF3 during etching of the SiO2. When the removal rate is less than deposition rate, net deposition will occur. Then the process becomes similar to the plasma enhanced CVD. Indeed, the reactive ion etch and the plasma enhanced CVD are pretty similar tool, except that the plasma enhanced CVD is typically heated. Here the temperature is not types of the plasma. First, plasma etching in the barrel etchers. Okay, what is a barrel etcher? Barrel is a cylindrical, this is the barrel. Chemical etching only, isotropic and selective, like pure wet etch, use plasma shield to keep ion bombardment from wafers, thus very little damage. Poor uniformity edge to center. From edge towards center, the uniformity is poor. Used in non-critical steps such as photoresist removal by the oxygen plasma. So this is the barrel, this is the wafer, this is the shield, the plasma is created here. This is the gas inlet to be reacted and this is the quartz tube in the wafers are implanted. So this is the side view. This is the barrel, as we can see in the figure. This is a quartz tube. Then next is the downstream etchers. Plasma is formed in a cavity which is separated from the etching chamber. Wafers are shielded from bombardment. Only neutral free radicals can reach wafers. Etching is completely chemical and isotropic. High selectivity is achievable. Plasma may be generated either by using a RF at 13.56 MHz or by using a microwave like 2.45 GHz. So the gas is inlet here is here. The plasma is created using a RF power and this is the etching chamber. In a reactive ion etch, due to its simultaneous anisotropy and selectivity, reactive ion etch is intensively used, works for most semiconductors in the dielectric materials, okay for some of the few metals that form volatile etch products. In reactive ion etching, ion energy is low and its number density is also very low, thus negligible etching by the ion bombardment. The name reactive ion etching is very misleading since ions do not contribute directly to etching, it just helps chemical etching. The main etching process is done by the chemical reactive substances. These ions provides the directionality only. So the complete name is reactive ion etch. Now, what is the relation between the ion energy versus temperature for the plasma? As we can see from the graph, as the pressure decreases, so we are stepping towards the physical methods, the ion energy increases. As the pressure is low, there is a more ion energy, and as the pressure increases, the ion energy becomes less, that is the directionality is loses. We are stepping towards the chemical etching. So low pressure increases mean free path as well as the voltage drop near wafer electrodes, both of which then finally leads to more energetic and directional ion bombardment, thus more anisotroping, but less selective and slower etching rate due to low ion or free radicals density. High pressure greater than 100 millitor, short mean free path, low voltage drop and isotropic chemical etching. Thus, it is desirable to have a low pressure plasma with high ion density. Plasma mode, the pressure is greater than 100 millitor, while in case of the reactive ion mode, the pressure is maintained between 10 to 100 millitor. In the sputter etching, pressure as low as possible as long as the plasma can be sustained, but still very low etching rate. This is a question for you. The reactive ion etch with tilted wafer will etch vertically or not? So in the last, we are having a summary. Chemical etching, free radicals react with the materials to be removed. Physical etching, like sputtering, ionic species accelerated by the built-in electric field bombard the material to be removed. In an ion-enhanced, combined chemical and the physical processor, higher material removal rate than etch process alone, example, reactive ion etching. So this is the last. These are the dry etching techniques. This is the pressure to be maintained. What is the particular species that in the reactive plasma, the pressure should be this. Low energy bombardment is there. While in the case of reactive ion beam etching, the pressure is very low. And there are reactive neutrals which are possible for the. So these are the three etching processes that are to be compared. Wet etch, then reactive ion etch, and this is the physical etching examples. Each rate in the chemical is of course very high, in the physical very low. In reactive ion etch, high along with controllable. The selectivity for the chemical etch is very good, while in the case of the physical etch, it is very low. In the reactive ion, this is reasonable and controllable. By time, if we want to go for the chemical etch, we have to see the limit of time. This is also by time as the optical mode. So this is plasma etching summarized, reactive ion etching summarized, and the remote etching to be summarized.